In today's Illustrator Vector tutorial by Satori Graphics, we learn how to make Illustrator Vector buttons in an easy to follow, step by step method. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. The first thing we need to do is to select a gradient of fill without a stroke in the color palette, and then take the ellipse tool. Hold down shift and click and drag to make a perfect circle. If you open the gradient window here, you can adjust your gradient to whatever you feel looks best for your vector button design. Next, in today's Illustrator Vector tutorial, we need to make another circle, but this time with the white fill only. Then open up the Align window and select both circles. You can now align them perfectly like so. Add a gradient fill to the white circle, and then in the gradient window, change the gradient to a dark grey to a light grey. Set a direction to minus 45 degrees for a vector button design. Then, in the colour palette, add the same gradient to the stroke. The direction of the gradient on the stroke needs to be 120 degrees. And then we can increase the stroke weight like so. You can select both circles and then resize them in place if you hold down shift and the alt option key at the same time. Just a quick tip for you all in today's Illustrator Vector tutorial. In the Illustrator preferences, it'll help if you scale your stroke options, as well as use the same smart guide options as mine here. We now need to open up the layers window located in the drop down menu, or you can simply press F7 on your keyboard. Select the white circle and copy it with Command or Control C, and then paste it into place with Command or Control F. Now you have two of the same circles in the same position for your vector button. Click the eye icon to hide the colored circle and then lower the white circle. Select the remaining circle and turn off the stroke, as well as adding a black fill. Hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate the circle like so, off to the lower right. Bring the original circle to the front, and then change the lower right circle to a white fill. Hold down shift and click both circles. Then go up to Object, Blend, and Blending options. Select specified steps and type in something like 800. Now go back up to Object Blend, but this time click Make. You will now need to open up the transparency window and change the blending mode to Multiply, which will really add to the 3D effect on today's Illustrator Vector button design. Also, lower the opacity somewhat to the shape. Make the other layers visible in the layers window, and then drag the shadow below the white circle like so. As you can see, the vector button is taking shape in today's vector tutorial. By pressing A on your keyboard, you access a direct selection tool, and then you can adjust and manipulate the shadow shape. There are just a few finishing touches to make in today's Illustrator Vector tutorial. I actually made a very slight error, so please open up the gradient window and then select the white circle. We need to change the direction of the gradient on the fill and the stroke. The fill was set to minus 45, but it needs to be 120. and the stroke was 120, but it needs to be minus 45. Now the lighting matches the shadow shape. Lastly, I will show you how to add typography or a logo on top of the vector button in a stylish way. Place the logo or the text on top of the vector button, and then in the transparency window, change the blend mode to overlay. Copy the layer with Command or Control C and then paste it in place with Command or Control F. You can then duplicate it over to the other button. So these vector button designs are great for posters, infographics, web graphics, and also flyers. I hope you enjoyed today's Illustrator vector tutorial and you found it useful. I hope to have t-shirt samples here by tomorrow, as I want to examine the quality of the fabric and the print product, which I've been told is very good. So I hope to have the t-shirts actually on sale for around January the 3rd. Also, I have my camera here on Friday and I literally cannot wait for that to come. But I hope you all had a very merry Christmas and you had a pleasant time with your friends and your family over the weekend. The new year is nearly here, so I send out positive vibes for you all for 2018. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.